Hey guys, hello everyone, a very warm welcome back to my channel Awan Anju. So from today onwards I'll be starting with the topics of world history because we have to go into the history as well. So before going into the core history, we need to look at the world history. We need to know the sequences in the world, how they were and how they laid a foundation for what we see today as the history, okay, that has been there. So I'm going to begin with this topic. So for all the people who are new to this channel, hey everyone, my name is Awan Anju and this channel is Awan Anju. I welcome you all. So I've already created many of the series, many of the topics of GS, okay, already has been created, and they are the free UPSC preparation topics where I give in-depth explanation as well as analysis of the various topics. I've already covered topics like polity and constitution. I've covered the topics international relations. I've also already covered the topics of your internal security, so you guys can check those videos out. Just go right now, check those videos out. Also, I have started, apart from this, I've started UPSC optional series as well, where I've already created one of the videos, okay, so you guys can watch that also. So optional for zoology, okay, so this is optional that you guys cannot actually, it is very difficult to get it online, okay, when you are studying it, it is a difficult task. You actually don't have these things and even the coachings are not there. So I've decided to create that also for your benefit, for all the biology people who are there, or if your friends are have chosen biology optional, and to be more specific zoology, so you guys can just share that videos with them also. So you can check the GS videos also, and from today onwards I'll be starting up with the world history. And the thing that we have to talk about today is going to be the American Revolution. That is going to be the center of attraction today. So before going into the video, I would like you all to just go right now, just hit that subscribe button in front of you before I start, because this is very important for all of us to know that yes, you guys are getting benefit from the video and putting in the efforts. So I should at least know that you guys are getting the benefit and you guys want me to create more of these videos. Okay. Also, if you like the video, then leave a like to let me know that yes, you guys liked the video, and please share it with your friends who need it. All the people who either need optional or who need GS, you can just share with them also these videos. So now, without any further ado, let's begin. Okay, so let us begin. So I would like to first of all start up with something basic, okay, because these are the things that you need to know before going into the American Revolution. There is a very important thing, a very important chart kind of thing that I'm going to draw here. So I have 18th century here with me, I have 19th century, and I have 20th century. So I'm going to divide all of them and then I'm going to make you all understand the relation between them and how all of these led to the creation of what we call as a revolution. Okay, so earlier people were not interested in any kind of revolution. They were taking the things that were there, you know, imposed upon them by the colonies, by the colonized people, and they're really not into just thinking about a revolution. So how does that all happen? Okay, now first of all let me tell you that this 18th century was also called as the age of revolution. Okay, so you have to understand this thing, and I'm not going to write everything on the board because I am limited with a mouse, so I cannot actually write much, but you have to note everything I speak, okay, and all the things that you feel like writing. So this is known as age of revolution. So there must have been something that why it is called as age of revolution. So first of all, there were certain revolutions, like if I want to point out, like industrial revolution, I'm writing IR, just write the full form, okay. And there are other revolutions that were like say French revolution, okay, and there were the revolutions like American Revolution. So all of the revolutions that basically happened in the 18th century, okay, so that's why 18th century is of much significance to all of us. Okay, now when I talk about this these revolutions, so what does these revolutions led to? So these industrial revolution, okay, the industrial revolution बेसिकली रेड लेड टू द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ इंपीरियलिज्म इन 19th सेंचुरी, इंपीरियलिज्म, ओके, इन 19th सेंचुरी. सो यू कैन नोट दिस थिंग. एंड बोथ ऑफ देम टुगेदर दे कॉज्ड द इशू ऑफ नेशनलिज्म. नेशनलिज्म, सो अ फीलिंग ऑफ नेशनलिज्म वॉज देयर. Okay, so this is what is caused by FR and AR, that is French Revolution and American Revolution. Now, both of them together has further led to, like this thing has led to world wars, world war, okay, world war and cold war. So when I talk about the World War and the Cold War, so in between World War and the Cold War, there was another revolution that was called as Russian Revolution. Okay, so you just write down Russian Revolution. We also call it as Fascist Revolution. So this is a chart which is giving you an idea about the different kinds of revolution and how did they led to different things in the 18th, 19th and 20th century respectively. Now, what happened before 18th century that led to revolution? That is also something to be pondered upon, because if you don't know the basics of how the revolution came up, how this topic came up, so we wouldn't be able to understand anything after that. Okay, so first of all, let us look at what was the basic thing about the what happened before 18th century that led to the revolution. So when I talk about let me just change the color of the pen to give you a better view. Yeah, so let's say there was 14th century. Okay, so I'll go with the 14th century. I hope the color is visible. Okay, so I'll go with the 14th century. So when I talk about the 14th century, so before this period, okay, this period was known as a dark age. So you can mention this word, dark age. So why was it called as dark age? There should be a reason. So the reason is this age before that was dark age because there was no revolution, nothing. People were not even, you can say people were in a sleepy state and they were not rising against the you know, the discrimination and all the things that are happening around. Also here we can see the age of feudalism. So you can also mention that this was the age of feudalism age. Okay, so this was the age of feudalism. So you can say that before 14th century, this was all there. Then came the 14th century, right? And after 14th century, what happened is that there was a period of that we call as, which I want to mention with the other color the period is known as Renaissance, R-E-N-A-I. This period was called as Renaissance. So this Renaissance holds a significance in the creation of revolution. Okay, Renaissance is basically the meaning, the literal meaning is like a rebirth. Okay, so there was a rebirth among people. They rose against all the exploitations that are happening. And this Renaissance further led to the age of revolution, which is the 18th century. So age of revolution. So this is how it all happened. Okay, and you guys should know this thing. You guys should understand this thing, that how did all of these things happen. Okay, now something more about Renaissance. So earlier, before Renaissance, let's see that this is the period of Renaissance. Okay, so before that and after that. So I'm just marking it with the R. So this is a period of Renaissance. Now what happened before the period of Renaissance? People considered God to be the center, and they are a smaller part. Just touch both of them. Okay, so human are like a man, or the human is like a side character, and the God is in the center. Whereas after the Renaissance, what happened is that the man has became the center and God has became a part of, like, something not in the center. Okay, so this is the major difference that happened like before Renaissance and after Renaissance. Okay, that's why we call this to be as theocentric. Okay, this is called as a theocentric age, whereas this age is particularly called as anthropocentric. I'm writing RIC here. Okay, so anthropocentric. So this is the difference between both of them, theocentric, anthropocentric, age of faith and modern age. So this Renaissance in between has led to the age of from theocentric going to the anthropocentric. So this is how it was. Okay, so you can say more scientific temperament was seen amongst the people. People started to question things. People started to address the various, you can say their skepticism rose, and they wanted to find the answers. Okay, so that was something which is relating to Renaissance. Now I have a question. Why Renaissance? Why Renaissance? Okay, so for why you could understand that the 14th century, as I told you, it was a dark age. It was a feudal age where there was lots and lots of feudalism that is seen. Now what happened is that after Renaissance, what happened is that, you know, not after Renaissance but before Renaissance as well, like around this period, what happened is that there was trades that were happening. Okay, so the trades were happening. Now what happens is that if the trades are happening, so your ideologies, you know, you get to open up to new ideas and ideologies. Okay, so if the trade is happening, so what is going to happen is that you get to open up. So it actually led to the idea of urbanism. Urbanism is the idea that came, that emerged. Okay, also after they also there was a concept of called as which is called as the concept of old glory. Old glory. Okay, so this concept actually gained prominence, and people started to reflect upon their architecture, their own thinking of their old empires, their old architectures, literatures, and they started to think more. Philosophers came, thinker came. Okay, so that is something that happened after the Renaissance, and something that started to happen here, which led to Renaissance, which further led to the age of anthropocentric age, and people started to question, people started to have a scientific temperament. So this is how the story goes. Okay, now let me give you some idea about the literature etc. of Renaissance. I think that needs to be studied. Okay, so I'll give you an idea about the, let's see, Renaissance literature. Okay, so let me just give you an idea about the literature of Renaissance. So literature, so when I talk about the literature, so there were certain books that further led to people to think about Renaissance, which actually moved people towards Renaissance. The books like a book named Divine Comedy. Divine Comedy, which was written by a person named Dante, Dante. Okay, then the books like Utopia. Okay, the books like Utopia, written by T. Moror. Okay, then there were books like a very some of the important books are there. So there was a book on the Prince, a very very popular book, The Prince. It was relating to the polity, where people started to think about man as a center. So they are going to think about things like polity, they are going to move away from only thinking about God and basically trying to think about themselves also. So The Prince was a book which was very popular, that was written by Machiavelli, Machiavelle. So you can mention these names. So these were certain books that were there. Okay, so when I talk about art, so in the case of art, what is happening? If I talk about art, so art, in art we have certain people like Leonardo da Vinci. You have heard about Mona Lisa, Leonardo da Vinci, ठीक है. Then we have also people like Michelangelo. Then there were certain people who emerged in the field of science as well. So science, in the field of science, there were people like Bacon. There were people like Copernicus, who has given the theory of heliocentric. You must have known also this thing, Copernicus, heliocentric theory, Copernicus. Copernicus. I hope now it's better. Yeah, so Bacon, Copernicus, okay. Then there were certain protests and the movements that also happened, okay? So we can mention that also. Movements that happened because of Renaissance. There were certain protests to reform the Catholic Church. So you can look at the reasons of reform also, okay? So you can make out this thing that yes, Renaissance is happening, okay? Also, there were the discoveries of new geographical areas that were being explored, which these geographical areas, when they were explored, okay, like if you are exploring a new geographical area, so this exploration is going to lead to the thing like colonialism, okay, so that was also something that was there, fine, colonialism. So all of these things were there, and this is all that happened, okay. Also, there was a concept of nation state that also emerged after Renaissance. So Renaissance led to the emergence of nation state concept as well, fine. Now let me just move on to our topic. I've told you certain basics about the Renaissance and how did that help in creation of the today's, not today's, but how it led to the age of revolution of 18th century. Now let us talk about the next thing, that is the American Revolution, which I wanted to talk to you guys about, okay? So let us look at now the topic of American Revolution. American Revolution. Fine. So now, if I talk about American Revolution, so you should understand certain things. First of all, it started in, I'll give you a brief timeline, okay? So what happened in 16th century? Okay, the Europe has colonized America. Took over America, colonized America. Okay, so Europe has colonized America. Okay, when? In the 16th century. Now, there were revolts after this. Revolts, what happened in the revolts, how it led to revolts, we are going to study all of it. Okay, so there were 13 colonies in America that were created by the Europeans. Okay, this further led to revolutions, okay, against England, and in the 18th century from say 1775 to 1781, okay, so within this time frame it went up till 18th century, from 16th century to 18th century. Fine. So this is the basic timeline. Now let me talk about the policies that were coercive policies. So there was a policy of mercantilism. Mercantilism. This is something which is followed by, which was followed by the England, the people of England, the English people. Okay. Now, what was it? It was basically a kind of a economic policy. It was a kind of a economic policy. Okay. And it was a policy of regulation. Okay, now they said that there would be a mother country that is going to be England. Mother country is going to regulate the other 13 American colonies are going to be managed by this mother country, which is England. Okay. How regulation? Economic regulation. So in the economic terms, they are going to regulate. Okay. Now, the basic idea was that there would be a accumulation of wealth. Okay. Now this accumulation of wealth would further lead to how would this be done? This would be done through increase in the exports. Through increase in the exports and a reduction in the imports, mercantilism I'm talking about, okay, through an increase in the exports and reduction in the imports, which is further going to lead to a favorable balance of trade, which is favorable for the people of England. So sorry. This was their policy. This was the policy of people of England on how they would be managing the trades. Okay. Now, of course, it was coercive in nature. Why? Because it was based on exploitation. It was based on one-sided trade. If you are just exporting and not importing, okay. So a one-sided trade was there, and they rejected the idea of free trade. So this policy was based on all of these things. Okay. Now, people actually looked at it, okay, and people started to note that thing, that these are coercive for them, for whom? The 13 colonies of the America. The people started to look at it. Now, what happened? Now, what happened was that they, like I told you right now, let me create another timeline for you guys. England was there, right? So England is there. It colonized the 13 American colonies. American colonies were colonized by the England. They followed the policy of mercantilism. Mercantilism. Fine. This was what I told you till now. Now, after this, now till 1756, this was there. Okay. I'll just draw it like this. Till 1756, this was there. Now there was a war happened in between. This war in this period was called as Seven Year War. Okay, and this was a war which was between France. Please, I'm so sorry. I just sometimes just go in a running hand. France and England. Okay. So the war was between France and England, where France was defeated by England. So England won. Okay. So this was the Seven-Year War. It इट हैपन टिल 1763. ओके, नाउ इट हैपन टिल 1763. नाउ आफ्टर दिस व्हाट हैपन्ड इज दैट दिस इंग्लैंड इंग्लिश पीपल ऑन द 13 अमेरिकन कॉलोनीज दे स्टार्टेड टू इम्पोज स्ट्रिक्ट टैक्सेस एंड वॉट दे सेड एज एन आर्ग्यूमेंट फॉर द रीजन वाई द स्ट्रिक्ट टैक्सेज वर देयर. सो एज अ रीजन दे सेड दैट दीज स्ट्रिक्ट टैक्सेज आर देयर बिकॉज वी सेव्ड यू फ्रॉम द पीपल ऑफ फ्रांस, अदरवाइज द पीपल ऑफ फ्रांस वुड हैव कैप्चर्ड यू. ओके, सो वी सेव्ड यू फ्रॉम देम बाय विनिंग ओवर देम. नाउ इन रिटर्न फॉर द कंपनसेशन यू हैव टू पे दीज टैक्सेज. दीज टैक्सेज दे वर लाइक मेनी ऑफ द टैक्सेज दैट वर इम्पोज विच वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट, like the taxes on the stamp, okay, the taxes on sugar were there, the taxes on like all of these taxes, tea was also there taxed. So all of these things were like there were strict taxes that were there. Okay, now as I told you, if you would have noted when I was speaking, I have told you one thing that like after mercantilism was followed, so people started to take note of it and there was an kind of renaissance within them and they wanted to revolt against it, but they didn't revolt it in this part. Why? That's a question. If they were able to make out that mercantilism is happening and that is coercive for them, so they didn't revolted against it. So there should be a reason for that. Okay, so reason was that during this period, because of the 7 year war, they knew that if they are going to revolt, so England may get defeated and after that the French would colonize over them, so it is not going to do any good to them. Okay, so what they did is that they allowed England to fight France and defeat them. Okay, they allowed this to happen, and once this happened, then the strict taxes were also imposed. So the feeling of revolution became even more stronger, and then from here they started the revolution. Okay, after this 7 year war. So this was something that happened. Okay, now how this revolution happened? Now this revolution happened as there were certain movements against the colonizers. So the 13 American colonies, they opposed these taxes and they said no taxation, okay, without representation. This was their kind of a slogan, without a representation. No taxation without representation was their slogan. Okay, now what in retaliation what did English people do? They imposed even more taxes. Okay, so imposed even more taxes. Now colonies rejected the taxes, so like the tax on tea was very high. Okay, so what they did is that these colonies, they took the tea boxes and started throwing them in the sea. Okay, they started throwing them in the sea, and this event is what we call as the event of a very infamous event of Boston Tea Party. Okay, so this was the event of Boston Tea Party, a very infamous event. Okay, you might have heard this term also earlier. Now what happened is that there were after the Boston Tea Party there was the creation of some of the, you can say, certain parties were created. The parties like Continental Congress was created. Okay, so they sent a petition and to the Prince of England, which was rejected. So the petition sent to the Prince of England was rejected. This led to a war. A war began in 1775. Okay, and then there was a declaration of independence by them. Independence in 1776. Independence, okay, in 1776. During the war, there was a domination of England earlier, but later France also helped the 13 colonies of America to win the war against England. So this was how the story goes, okay. So this was something that you all should know, okay. So I've given you a brief, a great account basically of all the things. Now let me just give you what happened after it, an account of that. So what happened after that? What happened after that was that there was a problem. Like America was independent now, but there was a problem from 1861 to 1865. Okay, so there was a problem. What was the problem? So the problem was that America faced a civil war. Civil war. Okay. So the civil war was between the North America and the Southern America. Sorry, Northern and Southern America. So there was a civil war between them. There was a practice of slavery in the Southern India, in the Southern America. Okay, so there was a practice of slavery in the Southern America, which the Northern people found to be morally incorrect. Okay, it was their ideology. So there were, and Southern people supported it because it was something that they have been doing for a long time, and it has become something which is like very much certain and very much known to them, and they wanted to do it. Okay, so there was a civil war because of that. Okay, North is having that notion of they don't support slavery because there was an industrialization that is happening in the North. Okay, whereas in the South it was more of the agriculture base, it was an agricultural part, so they are in favor of slavery. Okay, so there was an ideological war between them, and it has turned into a civil war. Okay, so now because of this civil war, the then leader of America, Abraham Lincoln, he decided to go for a war in order to, you know, get to a peaceful term. So they decided to go for a war, and the South was defeated, and the civil war got over. So this was something all about American Revolution. I've discussed all of the things with you. Okay, so you guys, I hope you guys have made the notes. So in general studies, we don't have to go into much depth of things, okay. So I have decided to I've created this video to give you an outline and something that you can write in a GS, which is important from the point of view of GS. And if you are in the optionals, of course you have to of course you have to go in much more detail, but I am studying, I'm giving you this explanation relating to the part of GS only. So I'm considering that this is what we all need. Okay, so if you know this, so you can handle this part well. So I hope you understood it well. In the next video we'll be talking about French Revolution. So I'm going to be coming up with a video very soon. So till then, stay tuned, stay safe, goodbye, take care. And guys, just right now, just go right now, if you haven't subscribed yet, just go and subscribe to this channel. Hit the subscribe button. Let me know that you guys like the videos and you want more of it. So thank you so much, guys. Have a very, very nice day. Bye.